Babe, you want to watch a movie? Babe? Kids? Oh, yes, time for a nap. What's up guys, guess what? I've finally got my hands on an amplifier I've been dying to check out for a very, very long time. Of course, by now you guys know I own KRIX speakers and subwoofers, which are known to be a synergistic match with this amplifier. But now, I'm kicking myself, man, because as you guys can see, I don't own a dedicated home theater room anymore to play or even to test these bad boys out properly. But anyway, I can't wait to show you this to you guys as we unbox a brand new unit and take a closer look on just how special is the beastie ELEKTRA HD2 7-channel reference amplifier. Oh, almost forgot. Make sure you stick around till the end of the video because I've got something really exciting and special to share with you guys. Let's go. So this improved version of the ELEKTRA HD2 reference amplifier retails for about $4,400 Australian, and I gotta say, man, a big shout out to the boys at Sydney Hi-Fi in Castle Hill for hooking it up and for teasing me with the unboxing of this unit. For those of you that would be interested, this amplifier also is available in 2, 3, 4 and 5 channel versions, and in the box it comes with the power cord, your user manual, and of course plenty of foam for protection. For those of you that have not heard of the brand ELEKTRA, well, you're missing out. This unit is carefully designed and built in Australia using the highest quality of components by the legendary Arthur Ruppus. KRIX being the main distributor of this unit, the beast completes the audio system chain and currently the only true high-definition multi-channel amplifier which has been specifically designed to reproduce full high-resolution audio from the latest movie soundtrack formats. The unit is handcrafted from custom components such as the two modules in the new circuit design, which are separated to isolate non-linear magnetic fields from the output stage that interferes with the input stage. This feature enables the amplifier to eliminate induced noise, achieving ultra-low harmonic distortion of ridiculous 0.0001% with high-definition audio. In other words, in my automotive world, if a Bentley had a baby with a Tesla, this will be it. It measures out 445mm wide by 370mm deep with 160mm in height, weighing in at a back-breaking 25kg, so around 55 lbs. It delivers some serious power and detail, rated at 190 watts per channel into 8 ohms or 225 watts into 6. And to the front, it is very minimal and kind of boring for some people, but I personally think less is more. As you can see, we have this beautiful faceplate with a simple blue power indicator and the KRIX logo, which also comes in the original ELEKTRA HD faceplate that's kind of similar to the Rotel amplifiers. The output devices are mounted directly on the massive, unique cast aluminium heatsink assembly that features multiple rib fins that provides a large passive cooling area that eliminates the fan noise. Around the back for maximum connectivity, it features both balanced XLR and gold-plated unbalanced RCA inputs, which is very common on most amplifiers at this price point, so you know it's built to last and future-proofed. One feature I'm a huge fan of, and not many amplifiers offer this, is the toggle switch on each individual input, which can be assigned to each individual speaker channel. You got your automatic DC 12-volt trigger in and out, and of course, the main external power on and off switch. Right at the bottom is the loudspeaker terminals that features audio file grade construction for them banana plugs or bare wire connectivity. And lastly, the power supply that features high current, ported low noise toroidal power transformer along with high power Nijikon filter capacitors, producing a total of 40,000 microfarad capacitance. I'm really digging the overall look of this unit. The elegantly finished anodized matte black texture is so sweet, and that transparent 1.6mm power coated steel chassis blends in nicely with the rest of my AV components. The solidity of the case integrates the heat sinks, which makes the housing mechanically rigid, providing isolation from the extraneous noise. If I was to compare this with my Marantz MM7055, even though it's not a 7-channel amplifier, I would say the ELEKTRA HD2 overall has blown my mind in terms of audio quality, so musical, so sharp, and in my honest opinion, it kind of just sits just a touch above the Marantz. I know it's not a fair comparison, but check these out. Let's compare some distortion percentages. The ULTA-LOW 7220 7-channel fully balanced amplifier retails for about $34.99, produces 220 watts per channel at 8 ohms, 0.07% total harmonic distortion. The Marantz MM8077 7-channel power amplifier, 150 watt at 8 ohms, 0.08%. And for the sake of things, I'm going to compare the Motiva XBA7 7-channel amplifier, which produces 200 watts at 8 ohms, sitting at 0.02%, which is not bad, but not close enough to the 0.0003% ELEKTRA HD2 reference power amplifier. Don't get me wrong, I love my Marantz amplifier and what it brings to the plate, but if you want that next level amplifier that offers big crystal clear sound with a minimal interface and crazy low distortion levels, this one's it, especially if you're hooking it up to them KRIX speakers. Unfortunately, I'm still in the process of gathering all my testing equipment to show you guys some additional in-depth information on some of these phenomenal amplifiers I've been playing with lately. But for now, I'm going to put my trust in KRIX and ELEKTRA Audio because I know they deliver high quality, superb equipment and speakers. It was an honor taking a closer look at this masterpiece, and once again, a massive thumbs up and thank you to the boys at Sydney Hi-Fi in Castle Hill for loaning me the unit. So let me know what you guys think about the ELEKTRA HD2 reference power amplifier. Is it on your wish list, or would you prefer and be into something similar like the Marantz, the Rotel, ULTA-LOW, or even the Motiva? For those that are interested, the link is in the description box, so check it out. I'm also super excited to tell you guys I'm in the process of building a mini beastie home theater room in our rental home, of course, for the time being. It's about 3 by 3 meters, which is going to be pretty badass for a small room. I'm talking new furniture, some world famous seats, which I showed a little teaser on my Instagram story. Of course, a full KRIX setup and much, much more. It's going to be a pretty busy couple of weeks ahead, so stay tuned for plenty of content on that, as well as climbing our way up to episode 40 on my room tour videos that you guys enjoy so much. Make sure you subscribe to the channel by clicking right about there and then click on the like button, because without your support, none of this is possible. Hang tight while I flick through on what's coming up next couple of weeks. See ya!